My name is Lily. I'm a pharmacist by day and a luxury addict by night. And today's video is gonna be all about the luxury items that I'm gonna be selling. I have a couple items here and they're actually all from the brand Louis Vuitton. And don't worry, I am not boycotting Louis Vuitton or getting rid of all the Louis Vuitton items in my collection. These items just happen to be from that brand. So some of these items have been featured in other videos on my channel and they might have actually been in my forever items in my collection tag video that I have on my channel, but you know what? Tastes change, lifestyles change, and items that may have worked for you in the past may not work for you now, and I'm just gonna be real. I'm gonna be telling you guys why these items no longer work out for me, and hopefully this helps you decide if that particular item will work for you or fit your lifestyle. So before I ramble on too much, let's get started on the video. So this item is actually the very, very, very first luxury item I ever bought with my own money when I became a pharmacist. And of course, when I graduated, I went a little crazy. I was like, oh my god, luxury everything. I need to buy Louis Vuitton everything. And by then, I've already watched a lot of videos on YouTube and I've gained some knowledge of the luxury items that I did want to add to my collection. So the very first thing that I'm going to be selling is this Louis Vuitton wallet. So this is in the Epi leather in this gorgeous red, and this was the very, very, very first Louis Vuitton item I ever added into my collection. And I did buy this pre-loved, and I saw this on eBay for $90, and I kind of freaked out because I was like, oh my god, you can buy pre-loved luxury items for that cheap online? And of course I jumped on it. It's just this really simple, like, kind of bills wallet. Like, there's no place for your coins and no really card slots. I don't know if this came with something else, like a bag or a bigger wallet, but I bought it like this and it came with a box and everything. So this is what it looks like on the inside. Still really good condition. The leather here is kind of scratched from like the cards I've put in, but the corners, still really good condition. And this is the back. One very good thing about Epi leather is that it's super durable, so even if you like scratch it, it's not gonna leave a mark. So sadly, I am selling this because, to be honest, I never use this wallet. I've gained a lot of other Louis Vuitton wallets and other luxury wallets throughout the years, and to be honest, I never reach for this. I don't even know how much I could possibly sell this for, because this is a pretty old style. They don't sell this anymore. To be honest, Epi leather has like really poor resale value. I don't know what it is about leather. I am sad to let this go, but I think it is time, because honestly, it's just been sitting in the box on my shelf for like 2 years. It's time to let this go. So the next item that may come as a surprise to you all, but it is my Louis Vuitton Speedy in the monogram. And this is the original Speedy. It's not the bandolier, doesn't have a strap, and this is in the size 30, I believe. Yeah, 30. The reason why I am selling this is because I've come to realize throughout the years of owning Louis Vuitton that I am not a top handle kind of girl. I am a tote bag girl through and through. You guys can probably tell through my love of the Louis Vuitton No Waves that I love totes and I love big bags. And this item, I sadly say, I never used. I even bought like a bag shaper for this and right now it's stuffed. But yeah, I never used this, and this is the very first Louis Vuitton bag that I bought. You know what? I think it's time to let this go because I just never use it and I can't justify having it just sit in my closet. So yeah, I am selling this, and it is sad to see it go, but it's time. The next item I'm planning on selling is my Louis Vuitton Agenda in the PM size in the monogram. I did a whole video on this on my channel, and to be honest, I haven't picked it up since I put it down. I still have the inserts in it. I haven't taken them out yet. I do need to take them out. But I did mention in my video all about this that I think the PM size is a little bit too small for me, and I think the MM size would actually be perfect. Because for me, I have big writing and I have like a big hand, so when it's like this small, it's just, it doesn't fit my lifestyle. So I am going to sell this and maybe put that money towards the MM size, which I'm pretty sure I'm gonna utilize. I actually think my next agenda would be the Demi Aubin print. The monogram print is gorgeous, but I think the Demi Aubin print is even more gorgeous, and I think that would fit into my lifestyle a little bit better than this inty teensy agenda that I never use. So the last item that I am going to sell is the biggest item, and that is my Louis Vuitton key ball. And again, I did do a video about this key ball on my channel, so if you wanted to check that out, I will link it below. So this key ball I did buy pre-loved, and it is the size 45. It is the bandolier version because it does have the strap, and it came with this thing, I don't know what that is, and the luggage tag. So this luggage tag, obviously, I'm going to keep because it does have my initials on it, so I'm not gonna sell that. Okay, my arm's getting tired, so I'm just gonna put this down. I do think it is time to let my key ball go because honestly, it is just too flashy. And I know a lot of people love the Louis Vuitton luggage items and all their luggage pieces, but to me, when I use this, I am just super aware that it is with me, and I'm like always afraid of getting mugged or getting robbed. So if I'm at the airport or even driving in my car with it, like I'm just super afraid that I'm gonna get mugged because it's huge, right? Like the print is huge, it's flashy, it's gonna draw attention. And I did mention that in my video about this. I don't like having items that I am scared to use. So there's a difference between like scared to use the item because I don't want it to be ruined, and then there's the scared to use the item because I'm scared of being robbed. Like maybe it's just my mentality. Like I don't live in a bad neighborhood or anything like that. Like I live in Canada, but it's just having it with me, I feel like people are like, oh, well, look at that Louis Vuitton bag, or look at that luggage tote. Like, I don't know. It just kind of draws attention that I don't want. So I do think it is time to let it go. I am sad that I am going to be selling this, but you know what? I can put the money towards something else that I will use constantly and love. Alright guys, that's my video for today. These are all the items that I'm planning on selling, and it is bittersweet having these items that have been in my collection for so long and just selling them, but you know what? It is time for a change in my life, and don't worry, I am not like going broke and like selling all my Louis Vuitton items. I just think that it is time to put these items towards a better home with a person that will use it, unlike me. They're just sitting in my house right now. So hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you have any questions for me at all about these items or lecture items in general, please leave a comment down below. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't yet, please hit the subscribe button, join my YouTube family, and until next time, bye!